Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayhi wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlil fala hadiya lahu wa nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu amma ba'd fa'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim bismillahir rahmanir rahim wa qala Allahu tabaarak wa ta'ala fi shani habibihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قل إنني هداني ربي إلى صراط مستقيم دينا قيما ملة إبراهيم حنيفا وما كان من المشركين أمنت بالله صدق الله العظيم الحمد لله all hamd all praise all thanks all gratitudes and gratification belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala our Malik Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Khaliq, our Razik. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who in his infinite mercy, never-ending mercy, who has created us, who is our owner, our nourisher and our sustainer. And after sending hamd on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we send durood, Salams and salutation upon Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Khatam al-Nabiyin Sayyid al-Anbiya. My dear respected elders, learned brothers and sisters, Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And before I commence, I know we have a very short time also, I'll try to as concise as possible make this very fast inshallah. But before I commence, I would like to say, Sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that we fill all of the gaps and the rows that is in front of us, inshallah. There's a lot of space in the first masala, especially, and then therefore the second and third. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the companion said that if we were to know the reward for the people who is going to be leading the salah, the mu'adhin, and the people on the first saf, we will be actually physically fighting for this. There's still another gap over here, let's fill it up, inshallah. There's another one here also. Don't leave the rewards behind. And just keep filling the gaps, inshallah. MashaAllah. Alhamdulillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us. We are so favored and fortunate to be amongst the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Such that all of the Anbiya's and the messengers that have come from the past, they also wanted to be amongst the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they weren't given the opportunity, excepting Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam, who is blessed to be amongst the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we, the mere human beings, the layman, is allowed to be amongst the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we do not recognize how important and how blessed we are to be fortunate to be amongst the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells that well, we are the last of the nation to come, but we will be the first to be given entry into Jannah, inshaAllah. So our time that we are going to spend in the day of reckoning is going to be limited as opposed to those people who have come thousands and thousands of years prior to us, my dear brothers and sisters, subhanAllah. Such is the blessings. We are blessed to be in this blessed month of Zulhijjah. We have just completed the 10 days of Zulhijjah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us that there is immense blessings and reward in these days. And we have seen the rituals performed from all of the hujjahs that have gone by, and those of us who were not able to make it to perform our hajj, to do the zibah, the sacrifice of the animals, inshallah. My dear brothers and sisters, there's reward. There is great reward for those of us that who are not as fortunate as those who were given the invitation, because we can have intention, inshallah, for how many years? to go to perform our Hajj, or if it is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give us the invitation to go to the sacred land to visit the Ka'batullah, we will never be able to enter into the land, inshallah, my dear brothers and sisters. So those of us who were given the ability and Allah, the blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we can perform our Hajj, alhamdulillah. Those of us who have not been given that opportunity as yet, make intention. It is the intention that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would like to see from us. And if it is that we passed away, as long as we have the intention, we will be given the reward that we have performed the Hajj. Such is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. He is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. He's forever, continuously wanting to be showing and showering His mercy upon us. His mercy is everlasting, never ending. He is continuously encouraging us to do good. We are insan. The root word, one of the derivative of the word of insan is nisyan, which means to make mistakes. We human beings continuously make mistakes. We are continuously making mistakes, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is continuously encouraging us so that we will be able to raise our hands and ask maghfirah and istighfar and ask forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He's continuously giving us the opportunity. My dear respected elders, learned brothers and sisters, are we taking these opportunities? Are we utilizing the opportunities? We have to question ourselves these. The days of Hajj has come and gone. And is it just a ritual that we have acted upon because of all of the nations have done it, our parents have done it, and our Jamaat is doing it? Is it just a ritual that we are following? Or do we know what is the purpose of the sacrifice that has gone down? The sacrifice of Hazrat Adam to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We know one of the major sacrifices is that of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam and Hazrat Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. But do we know from the very beginning of time Hazrat Adam alayhi salatu wasalam all the way to Prophet Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasalam, from different tribes and different nations and times that have gone by, there were sacrifices upon sacrifices that were made. In the time of Hazrat Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, he was sacrificed from the heavens to the earth, so that this is where we are here currently. Habil and Kabil, we know of the story of Habil and Kabil. They had to make their sacrifice, their offering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Habil, my dear brothers and sisters, he was the one that sacrificed the most plumped animal that he had. And Kabil, he was just a regular farmer, and he sacrificed, and he wanted to say, well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has everything. So he will just give Allah whatever it is, the refuse. Gave him just, you know, the basic stuff. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rejected his sacrifice. And from this, my dear brothers and sisters, from time has gone by, that one of the greatest sacrifices that we have known, even that of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we know of the sacrifice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But one of the most beautiful sacrifices I like to speak about is that of Hazrat Ayyub alayhi salatu wa sallam, mashallah. Hazrat Ayyub alayhi salatu wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with everything. He had land, he had wealth, he had family, he had everything, you name it, he had it, my dear brothers and sisters. Subhanallah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed a test in front of him. He placed a test in front of him where he took away all of his household. He took away his land. He took away his animals. He took away his crops, his children. He even gave him a disease throughout his entire body, where in which the villagers and they didn't want to have anything to do with him. He was cast into the jungle. And even whilst he was there, my dear sisters, mashallah, his wife, his Jawj, was the only one that would take care of him. From this we have to benefit and learn also, my dear sisters, that when we have an atrocity and calamities, we should stick together. Our husbands and wives, there are so many lessons to be learned from this. Where our husbands and wives, we stick together no matter what. We stick together, inshallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to reward the zawj for that also, my dear brothers and sisters. Subhanallah. But even whilst he was in the jungle, the shaitan, he did waswasa upon his wife and said that he could cure Hazrat Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam. But this is what she should do. When his wife came back, Hazrat Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam wife came back to him, he said, no, this is the waswasa. In fact, he scolded her, my dear sisters. He scolded her for this. But still, this is the perseverance that he had. This is from the the sacrifice that he did, my dear ones. We as believing men and women, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُلْ إِنَّنِي هَدَانِي رَبِّي إِلَىٰ سِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمًا دِينًا قِيَمًا مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that indeed his lifestyle, إِنَّنِي هَدَانِي, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided, my guidance is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the straight path, Dinan Qiyama Millata Ibrahim, the same path that Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was guided upon. And we know the guidance of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. He was given the laqab of Khalilullah. Do you know what is this? To have the friendship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was given the title to be the friend of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala befriended him. So much so that because he had tawakkal in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is tawakkal? To put your trust sincerely and solely to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us the dua in the Quran. Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakil, ni'mal mawla wa ni'mal nasir, ghufranaka rabbana wa ilayka al-masir, subhanallah. To put your trust solely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do we do nowadays? Something befall us, some harm, some conflict, some atrocities befall us, and the first thing we look for, we curse Allah. You know, what did I do wrong? Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cause this upon me? I do all of this, but yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused this upon me. This, my dear brothers and sisters, is one of the greatest tests. And we have failed the instant that we question, why is it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has caused something to befall me, the harm to befall me? But yet, when every single day that we go about our lives, we are breathing the air that we breathe. This is from the Rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are having all of our limbs, all of our digits, our eyes that we can see, the nose that we can hear, we can smell with, the air that we can hear with, the tongue, the lisan, mashallah, this little piece of meat that we have in our mouth could be take us into Jannah and could befall us into hell. MashaAllah. My dear respected elders, learned brothers and sisters, what do we learn? We have to realize from this month, this beautiful month, we have just passed the month of Ramadan. And we have learned so much from the month of Ramadan. And we are supposed, from the month of Ramadan, we are supposed to be prepared for the coming month. And just 2 months after that, we have the month of Zulhijjah. MashaAllah. Where in which we should be fully prepared with all of this Rikatul Qalb, our hearts should be soft from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout all of the nights in Ramadan, from the recitation and the listening of the recitation of the Quran every single day whilst we are reciting for ourselves, and during the night whilst we are standing in Taraweeh and listening to the Hufaz, mashallah. This is from the Qudra of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where in which He blesses us so that we can be able to soften our hearts. We are doing tasdeeq, meaning that we are doing the affirmation of faith within our hearts. And from this, the month of Zulhijjah has come back. The month of Zulhijjah has approached us, and half of it is almost gone now, my dear brothers and sisters. The days of Tashriq has already gone also, my dear brothers and sisters. The days of Eid has already left us. So now we have to think, have we accomplished, have we learned, what have we learned from the days of Hajj? Have we acknowledged its enormity, its grandeur in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We as believing men and believing women has been blessed to be given opportunities upon opportunities so that we can be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that we will be able to enter into Jannah. As I have started and saying that we are the last of the Ummah to come from the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yet we will be blessed and fortunate to be amongst the first of the Ummah to enter into Jannah, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us all the ability so that we will be able to pass the bridge of Sirat, inshallah. May Allah give us all the opportunity to be amongst those whom Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will do wasila, where in which he will personally guarantee our enter into Jannah, inshallah, my dear brothers and sisters. Subhanallah. We are so fortunate that all of the Anbiya's and the messengers that have gone prior to the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have liked to be in our footsteps, would have liked to have our position, where in which they will be able to be amongst the Ummah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Do we recognize how fortunate we are? We are not as recognized towards our deen as how we think we are. We look at the Sahabas, how they used to fulfill and come, how they would try and emulate Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The manner in which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walked, the way in which he spoke, the way in which he conducted himself towards his families, towards his non-relations, and even the way in which he conducted businesses to the Jews and the Christians. Do we think we as believing men and believing women will be able to calm ourselves to be amongst the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam just because we have been given the facility and we have been facilitated to be born amongst the time that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has come after that, but yet we are not emulating Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? We are not as worthy to be called amongst the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because we take it for granted, my dear brothers and sisters. We take it for granted way in which we are the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of the attributes of this blessed and beautiful month of Zulhajjah is to recognize the wahdaniyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To recognize, that's one of them, to recognize the solidarity of the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whatever creed, whatever color, whatever race, whatever nation, whatever country, whether we are poor or whether we are wealthy, we all stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the days of Hajj, whilst we go to perform our Hajj, with a simple tulle cloth, every single one of us. We wear just two garments, that's about it. The cheapest of garments, the same clothing that we will be shrouded on when we die and we go and we are buried, the same two garments we will be shrouded with whilst we are doing the tawaf and the azkar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This, my dear brothers and sisters, is to show the humility that we stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is with this same humility we should have when we stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every single time that we pray our salah. The same humility that we go and we do our tawaf and all of the time throughout the days of Hajj, we pronounce labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik, inna alhamda wa ni'mata laka wal mulk, la sharika lak, subhanallah. Do we know what this is, or do we just merely say it because this is what we are taught? Labbaik, here I am beckoning to your call, ya Allah. Labbaik Allahumma labbaik, I am here answering your call, Allah. How do you answer the call of Allah? You have to be invited, my dear brothers and sisters. We have to be invited to go to answer the call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So such is it that we are revered, that we are personally being given the invitation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But for those of us who are not being as fortunate as those who are present in the precinct of the Haram, my dear sisters, do we think we are less fortunate? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, never forgets all of the worshippers. Even for those of us who are not present, we've been given the facility to do the zabiha of the animal, and we will get the reward also. And those who are not sahib and nisab, those people who do not have the wealth, then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, then for the 10 days we do not shave, we do not pay our nails, we do not trim our hair, we do not pluck our pubic hairs. But the day after, on the day of Eid, after this, the animals would have been slaughtered, we go and we do all of the shaving. In this way, the hair that has fallen off from our face, that will be considered our sacrifice, mashallah. Is in the same way as you do the aqiqah of a baby. You take out the azab, the ham from the baby, so the head ham is falling out from you, my dear man, says, subhanallah. You know, this is the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored us with. We as believing men and believing women, we stand every single day. We do not know how fortunate we are that to have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as our Rabb. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Rabb of Al Alameen, the Rabb of everybody. But there are those obviously who are associated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. and they pray to some other deity that has no benefit to them. So when they pray to that deity, they do not have any benefit. We pray to the Rabbul Alameen, my dear brothers and sisters. The Rabb, the creator, the nourisher and sustainer, not just of this dunya, not just of the sun and the moon, the entire of creation of mankind, of jinnat, of the angels, the malaika, the entire of creation, my dear brothers and sisters. I hope and pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides us and protects us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the understanding of Deenul Islam, insha'Allah. Akulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullahi li wa lakum wa li sa'iril muslimin wa astaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim.